Hearts beat fast, colors grown missing. How to be brave? How can I love when I'm afraid to fall? Watching you sin alone. All of my doubts suddenly go away somehow.
Thank you. be right. Dear friends and family, with great affection for Nick and for Lexi, we have gathered to witness and bless their union in marriage. To this sacred moment, they bring the fullness of their hearts as a treasure and a gift from God to share with one another. They bring their dreams, which bind them together in an eternal commitment. They bring their gifts and their talents, their unique personalities, and spirits which God will unite into one being as they build their life together. We rejoice with them in thankfulness to the Lord for creating this union of hearts built on friendship, respect, and love. Please join me as we pray, asking the Lord to bless this union. Lord God, we thank you so much for a beautiful day. Lord, I thank you for the friends and family that have gathered here to witness this marriage with Nick and for Lexi. Lord, we thank you for them meeting, falling in love, and having the chance to go from here and build a life together. Lord, we pray that you would be the center of attention today, that we would see you as King, high and lifted up. We pray that you bless this day in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated. You look awesome. Marriage is one of the greatest gifts of God to man. It is the choice of two people to share their lives with one another. We have gathered in this place because Nick and Lexi have made such a choice. Nick, do you take Lexi in marriage covenant to live with her according to God's commands? Do you promise to be kind, compassionate, and forgiving, as in Christ God forgave and continues to forgive you? Do you promise to love her as Jesus loves his church, giving yourself for her? And do you promise to keep yourself for her for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Lexi, do you take Nick in marriage covenant to live with him according to God's commands? Do you promise to be kind, compassionate, and forgiving, as in Christ God forgave and continues to forgive you? Do you promise to love him and keep yourself for him for as long as you both shall live? Andy, just as God gave the first bride away, so you now stand in the same position. Up to this day, you've had the responsibility of guiding and protecting Lexi. Today, Nick and Lexi ask your blessing on their marriage. Who gives Lexi to be married to Nick?
Her mother and I.
You're stepping up. You come this way, center over just a little bit. There we go. You look great. Awesome. It is an honor to stand here today to perform the wedding of these two. I have known Lexi from her high school years and have known Nick's family for the past three. It's been an honor getting to know both of them as adults over the past few months during our counseling sessions. It was a great time to reconnect with Lexi, but equally as fun learning about Nick. Nick, you have for sure outkicked your coverage with this one, buddy. Andy, Laura, you have an incredible daughter who is full of life and obvious love for her family. Russell and Reagan, Nick is a fantastic young man. Both sets of parents should be proud. I love learning the history of what brought Nick and Lexi together. Nick is from North Houston, the Klein area to be exact, while Lexi grew up in Deer Park and then at the Memorial area. They didn't attend the same school as many people do, but instead were introduced by mutual friends. Neither knew that agreeing to meet would turn into the very reason we are here today. They lived in totally different areas, but continued to pursue each other long distance, both interested in one another, but also pursuing different things. Nick played baseball his whole life and had dreams of it being his future. And Lexi played volleyball at Dallas Baptist University. Both were busy. And Nick became a little too busy, leading to a break, which your dad called and asked me about that, by the way, at one point. Nick finally came to his senses and asked Lexi out again, which led Lexi to a very direct question that changed it all. What are we? That question and Nick's obvious answer is the main factor that's brought us here today. I always ask every couple I'm going to marry to spend some time meeting together. We were able to do so multiple times, and I must say it was such a joy to talk through the preparations and thoughts for today. In our meetings together, we discussed what marriage was and wasn't, the importance of talking through expectations of one another, how to demonstrate love to one another, and where their relationship needed to be founded. Demonstrating love to one another is something they both feel comfortable in doing because of their time together. Lexi is someone that feels loved the most when she can spend quality time with them. So Nick, let me give you some advice. While watching a sport on TV is technically spending time together, Lexi truly will be over the moon if you take her hand and ask her to go on a walk. Since you both love sports and the outdoors, being intentional is key. Go to a game together, learn a sport together, and if you really play your cards right, even sitting in a deer blind together could also count as quality time. Oh, and Nick, while you have a plan when you go to the grocery store, Lexi likes to zig and zag back and forth through the grocery store, and so why don't you just turn that into quality time as well?
Get your steps in.
Bottom line, put the phone down and just make time for her. Lexi, Nick is someone who truly feels loved the most when someone is willing to give their time and serve him. Sounds a little selfish, I know. But what that means is that he feels valued the most when someone goes out of their way to help him. So Lexi, that means if you know that Nick has had a long day, take the lead and do something that normally is his task. Maybe prepare dinner, or at least have it ordered in before he gets there. If you do this, Nick will quickly forget whatever tough day he had, and all the time will be spent with you. For both of you, take time to love each other based on what the other needs and not what you will get in return. Another thing I do with every couple I counsel is to have them write down their expectations of one another and not to share it until I can mediate that conversation. It's always a fun and sometimes revealing time, and the conversation with Nick and Lexi was no different. Lexi expects Nick to provide, be honest, and to cook, while Nick expects Lexi to speak clearly to him, hold him accountable, and spend time in the kitchen with him. Lexi will handle the laundry while Nick does do some of the cooking. While these are fun things to talk about, learning one another's expectations truly helps you avoid and communicate better when conflict arises. And I think for many in this room that are married, they could say conflict will arise. One of the best parts of the conversation was hearing them both express how they expected the other to walk closely with Jesus. Since they dated long distance, they began a habit of praying every night together, and that is something they desire to continue to do. Let me take just a few minutes to encourage you with a few things that have always helped my bride and myself. Set aside your time with the Lord and make a commitment to keep that appointment. Many times we get so busy doing that we neglect the time that we should be giving to the Lord. What I have seen is that when I am not humble before the Lord and respectful of the time I said I wanted to give him, my relationship with my wife struggles. I have a hard time being patient. It's hard to listen instead of speaking up and trying to fix her statements. In fact, if I am not centered on the Lord, all my attention and focus becomes very me-centered, which means it's hard to be the husband I need to be. The opposite is true, though, when I make sure my relationship with the Lord is in right standing. As you grow individually towards God, you will naturally grow closer together. Here are a couple of key passages in the Bible to remember when it comes to the marriage covenant you're entering. In Genesis 2, we see that God recognized that it was not good for man to be alone, and he made a companion suitable for him, and established the holy estate of marriage. The Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and he slept. Then he took one of his ribs and closed the flesh at that place. The Lord God fashioned into a woman out of the rib, which he had taken from the man, and brought her to the man. And the man said, "This is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man." I love that it wasn't from man's head that woman was made, that she might be the head of things, nor from his foot that he should rule over her, but from his side, next to his heart, that he may cherish her, and from under his arm that he might protect her. The home is built on love, which is best portrayed in 1 Corinthians chapter 13. Love is patient, love is kind, is not jealous, love does not brag, and is not arrogant. It does not act unbecomingly. It does not seek its own, is not provoked, does not take into account a wrong suffered, does not rejoice in unrighteousness, but rejoices with the truth, bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. But now abide faith, hope, love, these three. But the greatest of these is love. This is a passage that I know is used in many weddings, but let me tell you, the truths buried in here are incredible and worth keeping near and dear to your hearts. You see, love is the reason sacrifice of one's rights, attitude, and life is even possible. When you understand that love is a sacrifice, then you understand how you can be patient, how you can be kind, and everything else that this passage says. It's not all about you anymore, but instead about others. Another thing I want to remind you of that we talked about in our sessions together is there's a difference between a covenant and a contract. God did not make contracts with man, and I'm so glad he didn't. Throughout history, his desire for us isn't to enter marriage with the mindset of a contract. Too many people do, however. A contract is something you sign because you want something to better help you. A new iPhone contract, a car lease, it can go on. In the end, you sign it without reading all the fine print. It's a legality. It's a means to an end, what is necessary to get what you selfishly desire. Today, in fact, I will sign a certificate that is like a contract, making this marriage legal. Even if it's intended to be so, you know that you can break it, pay a fine, and move on. It's not what God desires. A covenant, like a contract, is an agreement between two or more persons, but the nature of the agreement is completely different. The biblical pattern of covenant reveals five characteristics. Let me just briefly share these with you. Number one, covenants are initiated for the benefit of the other person. Think of that. A contract's for you, selfish. A covenant is to benefit someone else. Number two, in covenant relationships, people make unconditional promises. Unconditional. Number three, covenant relationships are based on steadfast love. In marriage, steadfast love refuses to focus on the negative aspects of one's spouse. Steadfast love is a choice. Number four, covenant relationships view commitments as permanent. Unquestionably, the biblical ideal is one man and one woman married to each other for life. As Christians, we must not lower this ideal. And fifth and finally, covenant relationships require confrontation and forgiveness. These two responses are essential in a covenant marriage. Confrontation means holding the other person responsible for his or her actions. Forgiveness means a willingness to lift the penalty and continue a loving, growing relationship. Ignoring the failures of your spouse isn't the road to marital growth. Today, as you get ready to say your wedding vows, I want you to really think of every word as a covenant with great value rather than a contract with an easy out. One final word of encouragement. Remember that you don't walk this path alone. Don't be afraid to reach out to others when together you face difficulty. Other hands are there for you, which is obvious even on this day. You have friends, You have family that want to encourage you on your journey. To accept an outreached hand is not an admission of failure, but instead an act of trust. There's not a perfect marriage, guys. No one in here is. I know they want to walk with you. So, Nick, will you repeat after me these vows? Lexi, I promise before God.
Lexi, I promise before God.
Our family and friends.
Our family and friends.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
To share my life with you.
To share my life with you.
In wealth or in poverty.
In wealth and in poverty.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
In good times or in bad.
In good times or in bad.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
I receive you as God's perfect gift.
I receive you as God's perfect gift.
Complete in Him.
Complete in Him.
I pledge you my loyalty.
I pledge you my loyalty.
And faithfulness.
And faithfulness.
Lexi, will you repeat after me? Nick, I promise before God.
Nick, I promise before God.
Our family and our friends.
Our family and friends.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To share my life with you.
To share my life with you.
In wealth or in poverty.
In wealth or in poverty.
In sickness or in health.
In sickness or in health.
In good times or in bad.
In good times or in bad.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
I receive you as God's perfect gift.
I receive you as God's perfect gift.
Complete in Him.
Complete in Him.
I pledge you my loyalty.
I pledge you my loyalty.
And faithfulness.
And faithfulness.
Go ahead and give them both to me. Go ahead and give them both to me. I'll take them off. Yeah, we'll just do it. Got it. Perfect. Today you have chosen rings as a token of your unending love. These rings are an outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual commitment, reminding us of the union between Jesus Christ and His church. The ring is endless and fittingly represents the permanency of the marriage union. Nick, every time you look at this ring on Lexi's finger, let it remind you that on December 10th, 2023, you gave this ring as a tangible symbol of a spiritual commitment. As we examine it, we know that it is a circle without beginning or an end. Let it remind you that your love is endless and your commitment forever. Nick, place this ring on Lexi's finger and say this to her. Lexi, with this ring.
Lexi, with this ring.
I pledge to you my life.
I pledge to you my life.
My love.
My love.
And my loyalty.
And my loyalty.
Until death.
Until death.
You ready for yours? Okay. Lexi, every time you look at this ring on Nick's finger, let it remind you that on December 10th, 2023, you gave this ring as a tangible symbol of a spiritual commitment. Lexi, place the ring on Nick's finger and say this to him. Nick, with this ring.
Nick, with this ring.
I pledge to you my life.
I pledge to you my life.
My love.
My love.
And my loyalty.
And my loyalty.
Until death.
Until death.
While these two have committed themselves to each other, and before we declare them as husband and wife, they have chosen to take a few moments to pray together. I'm going to ask their parents, Andy and Laura and Russell and Reagan, to join us for this time. And as friends and family, I would ask you to spend this time praying for God to move mightily in Nick and Lexi's marriage. Let's step back this way. Yeah, let them up there with us. All right. Y'all get them. We're right here. Yes, come on in.
Wedding and Nick and Lexi, and just examples set for us where to live. Just pray that you just bless them and let them learn more and more about you each day. And just grow together and just remember for them. It's all about praising you and serving you, and just bless them, Father.
Lord, I thank you for this day. A special day it is, Lord. Just, Lord, I thank you just for Nick, just the way that he's pursued Lexi doing the Lord. And Lord, just Father, you just pray that somehow I'll take care of your little girl, dear Lord. I know that Nick will do that, dear Lord. More importantly, take taken care of her, that he'll continue to just nurture her and mm-hmm. lead her. Lord, that Christ will constantly be the center of their relationship. Lord, yeah. I thank you for Russell and Reagan and just the way that they've raised Nick and the things mm-hmm. they've instilled in him, dear Lord. Lord, I thank you for Lex. Just what a blessing that she's been to our lives, dear Lord. The young lady that she's been, dear Lord, I pray mm-hmm. that both of them will continue to impact people for you. Lord, like Justin said, they'll go through struggles, they'll go through hard times. Focus of their yep. marriage, dear Lord, and right in the center of it, Lord. You'll walk them through anything, and we know that, dear Lord. Lord, again, thank you for this special day. Lord, we're going to continue to just celebrate them. Give us a great evening. Lord, help everyone go just exactly how you'd want it to go, dear Lord. Have your hand right on this whole time together. Lord, we just love you. Just pray these things in your holy name. Amen.
Amen. Hey, it's a sweet time. This is really cool. You guys, it's a really beautiful thing for you two. You've got great examples, and they can tell you their struggles too. So what I mean, I really do mean that when you look and you see your friends as y'all exit here in family, these are people that want to walk with you. Like, take that serious. It's important to have that. And just understand that. And I think what a beautiful thing that you have both sets of pairs standing right here today. It's a great thing. Y'all good? Okay. Let you guys exit back off and we'll reposition. Come this way just a touch. Let's center back up a little bit. There we go. You're doing great. You feel good?
Yes.
We're doing this thing. That would love it. It's so good. Nick and Lexi, you have made big commitments before God and this assembly of your love and devotion to each other. Since you have promised to be true to each other for the rest of your lives, it is my distinct privilege to pronounce you as husband and wife. Nick, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I am pleased to present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Nicholas Wolf.